Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you major news developments from around the world. Our headlines: thousands demand repeal of UK policing bill after crackdown on Sara Everard protest. Bank employees go on strike in India against government's privatization plan. UN report reveals 65% increase in demolition of Palestinian homes by Israel. And protests continue in France as Senate debates widely denounce global security bill. For our first story, we go to the UK, where protests in the city of London continued for the fourth consecutive day on March 16th. Protesters had first gathered on March 13th to hold a protest and vigil for a 33-year-old woman. Sara Everard had disappeared on March 3rd while she was walking home. Her body was then discovered in the Kent Woodland area last week. A Metropolitan Police officer has been charged with the kidnapping and murder. Thousands of people have gathered every day since Saturday to protest against police and gender-based violence across the UK. Outrage grew following reports of police repression against protesters in Clapham Common on March 13th. The police were seen manhandling and grabbing women, pinning women to the ground and making arrests. Protesters are also demanding the repeal of the contentious policing bill introduced by the Conservative government. The Police Crime Sentencing and Courts Bill will give the police broader powers to crack down on protests. This includes limits on the duration of protests and other arbitrary measures, including noise limits. Activist groups, including Sisters Uncut and All Black Lives UK, have repeatedly pointed to the failure of the police to protect women and oppressed communities from harm. Moreover, police officers themselves have engaged in violence against these communities. Expanding police power under this bill will place marginalized people and communities at further risks, activists argue. Amid the protests, the bill passed its second reading in the UK Parliament on March 16th with a majority of 359 to 263 votes. It will now be sent to a committee stage for a detailed examination. In our next story, over 1 million employees from India's banking sector observed a national strike on March 15th and 16th. The strike was called to oppose the union government's plan to privatize public sector banks. The right-wing BJP-led government is proposing the privatization of two banks as part of a broader disinvestment plan. Several protest marches were held in major cities, including the capital of Delhi, on Monday and Tuesday. Thousands of people from progressive groups, farmers groups and student and women's unions also joined in solidarity. The strike was also supported by the major left parties in India. The call to strike was issued by the United Forum for Bank Unions. This is constituted of various organizations, including the All India Bank Employees Association and the Bank Employees Confederation of India, among others. Unions have stated that privatization will impact the working conditions of employees. It might also cause difficulties of access to poor and marginalized people living in remote areas. March 15th was observed as Anti-Privatization and Anti-Corporatization Day. The call was given by 10 trade unions as well as a united group of farmers. The central trade unions reported that protests were carried out in over 100,000 locations across the country. A strike in the four general insurance companies will be held on March 17th. A one-day strike will also be held by the employees of the Life Insurance Corporation on March 18th. In our next story, the demolition of Palestinian homes by Israeli forces increased by 65% in 2021. The first 2 months of 2021 reported the highest number of demolitions since UN records were first prepared in 2009. These findings were prepared by the UN Office for the Coordination of Humanitarian Affairs in the Palestinian territories on March 16th. At least 305 Palestinians, including 172 children, lost their homes and were displaced in February alone. Over 435 people have lost their livelihoods as a result of the Israeli-led demolitions. Israeli authorities often claim violations of rules or lack of permits to justify the demolitions. Palestinians and the UN have stated that the authorities also discriminate against Palestinians while issuing housing permits, forcing some to wait for many years. Seized land is often used to build illegal Israeli settler outposts. Israel has been conducting these demolitions in the occupied West Bank and East Jerusalem since 1967. As per the Oslo Accords of 1993 to 1995, it has total control of over 60% of the West Bank, known as Area C. There are more than 300,000 Palestinians residing in this area. Authorities have seized their land without prior notice in over 90% of the cases. The UN report also stated that Israeli officials target houses provided to Palestinians by humanitarian organizations. Israel has carried out 93 such demolitions so far in 2021, as compared to a total of 157 in 2020. Three Palestinian caravans were also destroyed in a village on March 16th. Palestinian land was also seized in Masafer Yatta, which lies south of the West Bank, on the same day. For our final story, we go to France, where protests against the Global Security Bill continued on March 16th. The legislation has been widely condemned, as it will expand police powers, including surveillance, while reducing accountability. Here is a video feature on the current developments surrounding the bill. Thank you.
there, they issue this national scheme of maintain of order, who gives policemen a lot of power, a lot of advantage to take over journalists. But it's true that since November 2018 and during all the year 2019, we have had a lot of aggressions of policemen against journalists that our union have shown with EFJ, European Federation of Journalists, on the platform for the protection of journalists at the Council of Europe. We see in 2019 that France has grown up in the position of countries where the relationship between police and journalists is not going well. And in 2020, this has continued. And this law is, again, another step in this, how you said, security state, a police state where police has a lot more power. We also say in France it's kind of minority report state. It looks like the movie Minority Report. They want to have the power, the decision, the power of broadcast the visual narrative, and that's not fair, and that's not human rights.
That's all we have time for today. We'll be back tomorrow with more news from around the world. Until then, keep watching People's Dispatch.